Hello, I'm David Bustos, the Chief of Cultural and Natural Resources. If you've never been out to Lake Lucero, it's a great place to come and see. Usually it's a dry dust pan of nothing much to see, but today it's really amazing. Whenever we get the water come in, you see the entire playa fills up and it actually becomes one of the largest natural lakes in the state, which is really incredible. And with it, if you look behind us, you can see all the different shorebirds and waterbirds out in the distance. Might be a little hard from the camera to see, but they're out there. Ducks and geese will come out, curlews, avocets, black-necked stilts. And if you look where I'm walking, I don't know if you can see me or not, but where I'm walking, it sure is real mushy and it's making a mess of things. But in other parts of the lake and not very far from here, we've been finding hundreds and possibly thousands of fossilized footprints from mammoths and dire wolves and camels and all kinds of things. So looks like they really enjoy the water as well. Great. Okay, yeah, so if you never been to Lake Lucero or to the monument and don't know, or just recently out here, if you look down around Lake Lucero, what you'll see are these selenite crystals. And the really neat thing about the selenite crystals is it's formed from all the water. So the water brings down the selenite from the surrounding mountains, and it all accumulates in the bottom of Lake Lucero and historically Lake Otero, which is a much larger lake. But as the water evaporates, as you see out here, as the water evaporates, the selenite, it'll become concentrated. And when that happens, it'll form the crystals. As the water slowly evaporates, then it'll leave behind just it looks like a forest of crystals as far as you can see, or a little city. You'll have all these crystals and they'll be standing upright whenever you first see them for miles and miles and miles. So that's the source of the gypsum sand. Those crystals, they break up and tumble and get smaller and smaller and all different shapes and sizes. And eventually you'll get the sand dunes that we see today. You can see they're so soft, they're easily broken with your fingernails, or you can easily smash them up and they'll make up the sand grains that we see. One of the neat things is whenever you first see a lot of these crystals, they're sort of amber in color. And they're amber because they have a lot of organic matter in them. But but whenever you look more closely at them, they're transparent. And as they break up, then they become white in color and they become more and more transparent. They look like our dunes that we see out there. Most of the crystals that we find on Alkali Flat and Lake Lucero that make up a lot of our dunes, they're not necessarily the really large crystals that we see out here. Some of these crystals can be 2 or 3 inches, or some of them can be several feet in length, and they make big plates. But the majority of the source of the sand actually comes from the very small crystals, the popcorn-sized crystals. And that's what forms whenever the water evaporates. And what's happened is just for, you know, a series for thousands of years, this process has been happening. The water will come down and then it'll evaporate. And when it evaporates, it produces a sheen of fine crystals as far as you can see. And then the winds will come, you know, March and April, those strong winds will come and just start beating up all those crystals and pushing them up to the tops of these dunes out here. And if you're out here after one of these big events, what's really neat to see also is you'll see very large ripples, some of them 2 or 3 foot tall. You almost have to jump over them. They're so big from the new source material that was formed out here. So if you ever get a chance to come out to Lake Lucero, take your time and look around at all the amazing crystals and some of the ducks and geese and whatever else there is to find. There's always something new to be found, and our scientists are always finding new species and a lot of neat associations with Mars and many other things. So hope to see you out here someday.